Good day, friends. Today we are going to study the stress management component of self-management skills in the employability skills portion of your information technology subject. Let's get into the content. What is stress? Stress is a normal physical response to events that make you feel threatened or upset your balance in some way. For example, you are actually standing in a ground where some sort of a play is going on, some games are happening. Suddenly, a ball comes your way. Immediately, what you will do, you will either duck or you will move away or you will try to catch that particular ball. Now, all these physical activities are in response to that particular incoming ball. Okay, so this is a this is upsetting your balance in some way, or you feel threatened in some way. Okay, when you sense danger, whether it's real or imagined, let's say you are actually in a forest area. Suddenly you see a king cobra on your way. Immediately, what will be your response? You will either try to go near it or you will, okay, there is a snake, it's a very big one, it is dangerous, I need to move away. Or let us say you are in a forest area and suddenly a a lion comes in front of you. What will you will be your reaction? Either definitely you are going to feel threatened, and then you will either try to run away from that particular situation or something else. Or let us take another situation. You are actually going on the road. Okay, suddenly your enemy sees you. Seeing your enemy, what you will do? Again, either you will try to face that person or again try to run away from that particular person. Anything. Okay, so this is what? When you sense danger, whether it's real or imagined, the body's defenses kick into high gear in a rapid automatic process known as the fight or flight reaction or the stress response. Let's see further. Stress management. Managing stress is all about taking charge of your thoughts. Now suddenly that particular ball is coming. You are actually in charge of yourself. So your mind tells you to raise your hands to catch that particular ball. Or your mind might tell you to duck. Or your mind might tell you to move away from that particular location in that particular direction. Okay, so taking charge of your thoughts, your emotions. Now, suddenly, let us say you are actually going in a roller coaster. What happens? Let us say this particular roller coaster is coming down from the higher point to a lower point. All of a sudden, it will be very, very moving, very, very fast actually. Okay. Again, you will feel like shouting at the top of your voice. Again, let us say this particular roller coaster is moving upwards. Slowly, it will move up. Initially, it will be moving a bit faster, but then as it reaches the topmost position, it will slow down, and then you will all be feeling very fear will be, that feeling will be there. Okay, what if I fall? Something like that. Okay, so you need to take charge of your thoughts, your emotions, your schedule. Now, what is this particular schedule? Let us say tomorrow I have an examination. Okay, so how do I manage my time? I need to prepare for four chapters and I have only 2 hours time. I have got 3 other homeworks to be done. Okay, now how are you going to manage your time? That is the scheduling of your time. That is very, very important. Your environment. If you are in a, what you call, shabby environment or a, let us say, unclean environment or a dirty environment, obviously, you will not feel like, doing a particular activity that you are doing. But it may also mean that, let us say, you are not feeling very well. Okay. Your environment. Let us say, if you are sitting in a calm area, quiet area, you can concentrate better in that particular, content that you might be doing or working on. Okay. And the way you deal with problems. Let us say you have this particular examination, how you are going to deal with it. Somehow you have to do all these particular tasks within the next day. So you have to actually try to complete the, you have to plan out. Okay, let me concentrate on 3-mark questions more, or let me concentrate on 5-mark questions more, or let me concentrate on 1-mark questions more. Okay, depending on the time that you have, you are going to deal with the situation. So that is what is basically your stress management. Managing stress is all about taking charge. The ultimate goal is a balanced life with time for work, relationship, relaxation, and fun, plus the resilience to hold up the under pressure and hold up under pressure and meet challenges head on. Now see, the ultimate goal is to have a balanced life. We need to have time for our work, our friends, our family members. We need to have time for some sort of a relaxation, entertainment. Okay, that is your fun or whatever, some game or something like that. And then you need to have that particular endurance. Resilience here is the endurance to hold up under the pressure. Let us say, I should not buckle up under the pressure, saying I should not fear coming into me that I will not have time to study for the exam. There is too much of portion. Instead of thinking that there is too much of portion, I need to think logically. I have got 3 chapters. From these particular 3 chapters, I need to study or concentrate more on certain areas from where maximum questions can come. Or my goal is to score around 50. What should I do for that? So, like this, you need to have some sort of a plan. That is the endurance. What may come? Okay, if it is, let us say this particular, your enemy has come. You need to have the endurance to run away. Or you need to have the endurance, that is the physical fitness to actually face that particular person. Anything. That is, to meet the challenges, you must have some, you must be physically fit. You must be mentally fit. Okay, that is your endurance. Okay. Should be good enough. Okay, that is what is your ultimate goal as such here. Or let's see what is the other part. Stress management refers to a wide range of techniques that enable a person to cope with psychological stress effectively. Now, this is another area. There are lots of techniques, strategies available. If you follow them, that is good enough. Any kind of stress that you might come across, okay, your parents may be in a great deal of stress. Okay, you can actually help them out by telling these kind of management techniques. Another thing, in a few months from now, you're going to face board exam. Again, you will be under pressure to score more marks, to satisfy your parents, to satisfy your relatives, to what you call have a good image over your what you call friends. So many things are factors are there. So we need to prove ourselves, isn't it? So actually, this is a kind of what you call pressure we actually tend to build on ourselves. Okay, that is what is psychological stress. We need to have some sort of a, what you call strategy or technique to get over these kind of psychological stress effectively. The second point, it covers all the tools and mechanisms that alleviate. Alleviate means reduce. Reduce chronic stress. Chronic stress is something that gets built up over time. Now this examination stress, that is definitely going to build up over time. Those who are not able to complete the day-to-day classwork or homework now will definitely feel the pressure down the line in a month or so. Okay, definitely they are going to feel the pressure, which could otherwise prove to be a lethal disease. It is definitely going to affect you. Okay, this stress will actually build fear. And this this fear will actually decrease your immunity. You will easily fall sick. On an important day, when let us say there is a preparatory exam which is scheduled on a particular day, a day before that you will have fever. And then people will say you are having exam fever. Okay, so these kind of things might happen because you are under stress. This includes a pool of techniques that assist individuals in eradicating anxiety and negative thoughts and work on their well-being. So basically, stress management is something very, very important in everybody's life. And you are in an important turning point of your life. Definitely, it is very important for you. Okay, so these are certain tools that will help you over this particular any difficult time that you might face. Let's go further. Stress management strategy. Now, see here, not all stress can be avoided, and it's not healthy to avoid a situation that needs to be addressed. Now, let me take a simple situation here. I need to, let us say I am a student studying in 10th standard, I need to score at least 90% in my board exam. And this is the goal I have set for myself in order to prove my abilities, in order to actually choose choose the career that I want. Okay, so what do I do? I have to get more marks, especially in 10th, which is actually going to decide my career. Okay, so again, I am actually giving way to some sort of a stress. Okay, but this particular stress is healthy. Competition is required. You actually have games, IPL games are there, in school, inter-school games are there, inter-house games are there. Why are we conducting all these games? Actually, these are necessary to build up your endurance. That is one thing. To make you physically fit. That is another thing. Okay. See, when you are physically fit, you are going to be safe from these kind of anxieties or stress compared to a person who is not healthy. Okay, who is not fit. Okay, so you need to have some sort of these kind of situations which will actually give power to you. Okay, it will put you in a situation where you are under some sort of a stress. But then that kind of a stress is definitely healthy. Okay, you should be able to get over that kind of stress also. You may be surprised, however, by the number of stressors in your life that you can eliminate. Now, this is something very, very, very important. Using these stress management strategies that I am going to list later on, you can actually remove a number of stresses that will come across your life. Okay, let's see further. Stress management techniques. Stress management techniques help to guide and empower individuals to maintain equilibrium, stabilize their emotions, and live a productive life. Now, let's get into these points. Keep a positive attitude. Now, this is something very important. Every day, we actually come across situations when we are not able to give our best. We may not be able to prove ourselves in all the conditions. Okay, there will be some condition where I will do very well. There will be some situation where I will not be able to do very well. So this, when I'm not able to do something very well, some sort of a negativity comes in. I need to actually learn from that. Okay. Now, let me tell you something very important here. Thomas Alva Edison. He actually is known for the invention of electric bulb. But how many of us know that he did not invent this particular bulb overnight? He actually broke so many equipments. He damaged so many things. Okay, thousands of times he actually broke certain things, and then only finally he actually invented this particular bulb. That tells us two things actually. One, if I do a particular task and I am not able to succeed, then definitely that particular path that I had taken, that approach that I had taken, is not correct. Thomas Alva Edison himself said that those 999 times that I failed actually taught me that those were not the right approaches to actually invent that particular bulb. So what do we learn? One thing is we should not the moment we face a failure, we should not run away from that particular situation. We should keep on trying again and again. Positive attitude. Okay. And thinking, okay, this particular method gave me a failure. I should not follow this. We have to learn from that. So a failure is basically a tool for us to learn certain things more. Even our Abdul Kalam sir also said, failure is actually an acronym for first attempt in learning. Accept that there are events that you cannot control. Now, you might be going for a particular important thing. Suddenly, because of some reason, that particular event may get cancelled. Now, because of Corona, so many things actually got cancelled, postponed. So many things have happened. Actually, many people have lost their jobs. So many things. But then, what do we do? We can't do anything. We have to accept. There are events which we cannot control, which are beyond our control. See the third point. Be assertive instead of aggressive. Assert your feelings, opinions, beliefs, instead of becoming angry, defensive, or passive. Now, when a situation comes that you, let us say, you want to put your point in front of your, let us say, friend, there you cannot become angry. I am only right. What you are saying is wrong. We should not say like that. We should not deal with that situation like that. How we should do it? Okay, your point is like this, but I feel this is my point, in which in my opinion will give us a better result. Okay, again, becoming angry, becoming defensive, passive, keeping quiet. I don't want to talk to this particular person. He doesn't listen to me. Defensive, this is enough. okay, I will not do. Whatever you do, you do. Okay, angry. Whatever it is, I am right. Okay, whether you like it, you be here or you go to him. Okay, something like that. Okay, there, which may not give us a good result actually. So what we need to do, assert your feelings, opinions or beliefs instead of becoming angry, defensive or becoming passive. Learn and practice relaxation techniques. Try meditation, yoga, tai chi for stress management. Now these are some proven exercises which can be done anytime. Okay, whether you are early in the morning or before the bedtime, you can do meditation, can be done anytime actually. But then you should know how to do it correctly. Okay, so learn and do it correctly. Okay, practice. See, these are not easy. Meditation is never easy. It takes lots of practice actually. I cannot do meditation, okay, for even 5 minutes. That is, I cannot, keep my mind free from my thoughts. Even for, let us say, 2 minutes. You should also try. Okay, it's not a very easy task at all. Okay, if you are lucky, you will be able to actually hold the thoughts. Okay, or without thinking, you can remain for, it's a challenge. Okay, let's say you can remain, you can concentrate on something or nothing actually. You should not concentrate on anything. That is, your mind must be empty. It should not get any ideas or whatever. Nothing should come to your mind. It's a challenge, okay? Nothing, it's very, very difficult actually. Practice will definitely help us. Exercise regularly. Your body can fight stress better when your body is fit. Okay, the person, healthy mind always is there in a healthy body. Now, due to corona, we are all actually inside the home. But you would have noticed, people are doing a lot of exercise even when they are inside the house. Okay, some sort of work they are trying to do. And then keeping themselves fit. Eat healthy and well-balanced meals. Junk food should be avoided. They are actually very good for your tongue, but then only for the tongue, not for the body. Okay, we should know our priorities. So, well-balanced meals are very, very important. Okay, let's go further. Learn to manage your time more effectively. Instead of watching TV or playing game for more than the given specified time. Let us say I have time to play only for half an hour. That's all. You should not spend more time than that. Okay. Recreation, entertainment is definitely necessary. Okay. Why is it necessary? Just to actually get over some bugged up feeling that you might have. Okay, after 4 hours of online classes, I need some sort of a break. Okay, so that kind of a break will definitely help. But then keep your time limited. Manage your time more effectively. Set limits appropriately and learn to say no. Now, this is something very, very important. Learning to say no is very, very difficult actually. To request that would create excessive stress in your life. Your friend actually will tell you, look here, if you do not come for the birthday party tomorrow, then that's it. I will not speak to you for the next 1 year. Okay, then what will happen? And the following day you have, let us say, an important exam test. So what will you do? Okay, friend is important or the test is important? Again, you should be able to say no to something. Okay, if you want to do well in test, definitely the party is not required for you. But if you want, your friend is more important, okay, even if I fail or even if I get less marks, no problem. I can have this particular test another time. Okay, so that is up to you. Okay, but then please remember, saying no to requests is definitely something very important. By saying yes to everything, actually you build a lot of stress into yourselves. Okay, make time for hobbies, interests and relaxation. Okay, this is again something very important. Some physical activity, mental, what you call recreation, are definitely necessary. You can join some dance class or something like that. If you enjoy music, you can practice music. Something, some hobby should be there. What you may actually play an instrument, or you may have an inclination to drawing, you may have an inclination to, let us say, cooking. You can help your mother. Okay, so many things you can do. Get enough rest and sleep. Now, sleep is something very, very important. As we become older, the sleep becomes reduced. Okay, and when that happens, then that is actually very, very dangerous for our health. Okay, so in your young age, you should be able to sleep for at least 6 to 7 hours without any break. Okay, at the old age, definitely you will wake up to once at least in the midnight or some time. Okay, and that is not a good sleep as such. Okay, your body needs time to recover from stressful events. During your sleep time, actually your body does a lot of repair work actually. So that is why it is something very, very essential. Seek out social support. Spend enough time with those you enjoy. Spend some time for social, you may use social media to some extent, okay, not too much time. Some time you can definitely spend. Okay, because this is during Corona, definitely we will not go to your relatives' homes or something like that. We will try to confine ourselves within our home. So WhatsApp or something like that can be definitely made use of. We can actually know what is happening in our friends or relatives' families as such. And then we can share our feelings with them. Okay, so that is something good enough. It actually diverts our mind from stressful situations. It gives us some sort of relaxation. Okay, spending time with your family, spending time like these kind of things. Okay, they are all something very, very important. Okay, seek treatment with psychologist or other mental health professional trained in stress management or biofeedback techniques to learn healthy ways of dealing with the stress in your life. Now, if the normal strategies like playing, spending time with family members, doing meditation, or spending time walking, okay, in the park, or doing some physical activity, going for jogging, if these kind of things are not able to relieve you from stress, definitely you need to go and visit a doctor, a psychologist, or somebody who is a mental health specialist who can actually guide you in a better way. Okay, so that can be definitely done. Now, what are the benefits or importance of this stress management? Let's see. It improves your overall health status. You are able to assume a more positive attitude and outlook in your life. It increases your productivity since you are able to focus clearly on your tasks. All these are definitely the benefits. There are more. You have a better control over your emotions and how you respond to it. And more importantly, you reduce or eliminate stress in your life. It improves your mood. It boosts your immune system. It improves your thinking ability. So many good things are there. So why not go for these kind of stress management techniques? Of course, right now you may not be feeling a lot stressed, but as the time will go by, in a month's, let us say 2-3 months time, definitely you will feel the stress building up. And in those times, definitely these techniques will help you be in control. Okay? Thank you and have a good day.